Hey, today we want to show you how to use tracking points to animate coordinate-based effects such as lens flare, god rays, shattered glass, text animation, and a few more. With tracking points, you can easily create a custom movement trajectory and pin one of these effects to it. As a result, the effect will move along the trajectory at the speed of your choice. Let's see how it's done! First things first, drag your footage to the scene, then go to the left side toolbar and select Tracking Point. Click OK in the pop-up window to accept the default settings, then click on the scene to indicate the starting point for the movement trajectory. In the next step, we are going to build that trajectory using movement vectors. Double-click on the Tracking Point block on the timeline and go back to the left side toolbar to select the Movement tool. Accept the default settings and create your first movement vector. Just click anywhere on the scene and then adjust the path manually if you need to. If you want a smooth curve, click on that second control point and start dragging the vector to achieve the desired result. Now that the path for the tracking point is ready, it's time to select the effect you want to bind with it. Go back to the main timeline tab, select your footage, then open the video effects. Here is a list of the effects you can animate: motion blur, shattered glass, lens flare, bokeh glare, god rays, shadow, and distort. For our example, we'll use lens flare. Once you've added the effect, go to the properties window and find the following settings: center coordinate type, switch to tracking point, tracking point binding, select the tracking point you created earlier. Alright, to adjust the atmosphere in the video, we're also gonna change the color tone of the lens flare effect to red. And here's the result. The lens flare is moving exactly along the trajectory we created earlier. Now, here's another cool trick you can do with the tracking point feature: animated title intro. So, suppose you want to have a piece of text in your video, or you want to create a stylish intro. We're gonna show you how to bind its appearance with the tracking point and any other effect of your choice. In our case, it's still lens flare. Okay, so we've added text to the scene, formatted it to our taste, and placed it in the middle of the screen. Great! Now double-click on the text block on the timeline and go to the text effects menu at the top. Select text shift position. It's an effect that makes your title gradually appear on the screen or disappear from the screen, letter by letter. Select the effect and go to the properties window. Check the following parameters. Effect duration should be fade in. Initial glyph position should be tracking point. Tracking point binding. Again, select the tracking point you want to use here. Notice that you can easily adjust the duration of any effect or text on the screen by stretching their blocks on the timeline. So here's the result. The lens flare is moving along the same trajectory as earlier, but now it's also sort of carrying our title, sending letters to their designated position. If you don't want the letters to be visible until they almost get to their spot, you can apply the recoloring text effect to the title. And this is what it's gonna look like. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial. You can do a lot with tracking points if you are willing to experiment and use your imagination. Leave your questions in the comments below. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Until next time. Tip 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 t